Get someone out here to River Row for this cash.
Sure thing, Cher. Heading your way now.
All right. What are we handling today?
Better not lose this.
On my way. Call me if you need me.
Can I get a resupply on River Road?
Coming at ya. Hang tight.
See anything you need?
Let me see what you got.
Don't. I'm out of here. Anybody follow you? Roy is rattled, scared of Greco, terrified of you. Heard he started sleeping at the warehouse, the only place he feels safe.
Good. Means I have an easier time getting my hands on him.
Once he's taken care of, we'll move in. Vito will turn things around. You'll see. That poor fucker Roy is back at the warehouse. Do what you gotta do.
Officers over here.
Got the best Boudin and new Bordeaux. But Boudin is just the beginning. We got andouille sausage. We got alligator sausage. We got spare ribs, we got beef ribs, and we got ham hocks. And don't forget my famous sausage balls.
What's the over-under on Greco getting rid of Mr. Thibodeau?
It's good odds if we keep losing money and merchandise like we've been. Roy don't have the balls for this kind of... Pusher.
This kind of thing's good for fellas like us. Battlefield.
Assuming the man hitting us don't speak in and cut your goddamn throat, maybe you should worry about that.
Huh? Things are getting...
Take him down!
Guess we put the fear of God.
Got him! Over here!
Leave it to me!
Cover!
You just another notch on my belt, bitch!
It fucking gone!
Phoenix can't put off, too.
Spotted him! Over there, shoot him for fuck's sake!
You got you now, dipshit!
Need to leave.
Gotta get behind something!
Things good again for you, Roy. Join my crew.
Great. That sounds great. Whatever you say.
See? Things are already looking up. Need you guys to secure the smuggling operation at the warehouse.
I'll send them over. And Lincoln, just cause Greco's a dipshit doesn't mean he's a pushover. He'll probably send out some of his men, have them try and take you out. So watch your ass. Get your hands on Greco and rough him up all you want, but don't kill him. That's for me.
Thank you.
I was in the 3rd Platoon Company C of the 614th Tank Destroyer Battalion during World War II. I trained as a medic, but I still carried a gun. Every man in our company was black. Army didn't know what to do with us other than they didn't want us fighting with the white men. Glenbach. Glenbach was that little French town up there near the border with Germany, and we were ordered to take it. Now, the Krauts took out 3 of the 4 anti-tank guns we had, but there was no way in hell we were letting them get the better of us. We were determined to show we was just as good, if not better, than every other soldier in the service. I don't like talking about medals I got over there. Only way a man survives something like that is through the grace of God. Doesn't seem right celebrating a little piece of tin. No one knows I helped Lincoln except for you and John Donovan. Not that I'm keeping it a secret, mind you. Just that nobody ever came around and asked about it.
Hey, Lincoln. Everything back to normal here now, thanks to you. Hey, Lincoln, that prick Greco threw me out on my ass. He can give a shit I got a pregnant wife at home. Nice to be back on the job is all I'm saying.
splash. New Bordeaux needs a professional football team. Urgently. Dear listener, our city needs the roar of the crowds on Sunday. The smell of hot dogs. New Bordeaux absolutely needs the added expense of a brand new stadium. One our city would foot the bill for, of course, along with all of the traffic and congestion that would come with a new stadium complex. Oh, and let's not forget the part where no team has been willing to offer us more than a 10-year contract. Y'all see where I'm going.
Greco's in that building at the end of the block. A lot of hooas in there. Probably face down a pussy right now.
You got any muscle with him?
Yeah, a couple of meatheads. I'll go around the front, you take the back. He tries to run, grab his ass. Nobody kills that prick but me. Fuck. Those are Marcano's guys. Cocksucker. Come on, back to the car, you drive. I'll cover us. Fuck if that little prick gets away.
Is that? How the fuck did Greco end up with my car?
He's a little fucked, that's how.
God damn it, why don't you just let Marcano handle this jackass?
Marcano would just kill the little shit stain. I want to take my time. Besides, until I can get at Marcano directly, this is the next best goddamn thing.
Point taken.
Out of here, the cops are closing in.
Hey, get the door.
Yeah. Come on.
Code 35, suspicious person and vehicle. Responding unit in.
Oh, it's not one thing, the fucking cops are on our ass.
What happened?
You crossed the wrong motherfucker, that's what happened. Now shut the fuck up!
be involved in this beat-off, you cocksucker!
Back to your place.
Yeah. Pull around to the chum shack in the back. And as for you, have a little dignity. Christ.
Help! Somebody fucking help! Help!
Watch out for cops. Don't want to get pulled over with this asshole in the back seat. Whew. Shit. For a couple of years there, I really thought I might be done with all the Jimmy Cagney bullshit. But here I am.
Ronnie, I kind of figured you for more the Edward G. Robinson type.
Look at you, kid. You know, God's got a sense of humor, too. It's sick as shit, but that motherfucker's got one. There, kiddo. Ride'll be over soon.
Please! I didn't do nothing!
Didn't do nothing? You were getting ready to fucking kill me.
I was just doing what Uncle Sal told me to do.
Nah, that fuck never liked me. I get it. But this? You never tried anything like this before.
I don't...
Come on, Mikey. Why do you want me gone all of a sudden?
He said you were a carpetbagger. Never should have been down here in the first place.
You want me to keep going? You got nine more!
Fuck! Listen, Jesus, he was worried you knew about the casino! And so we're gonna play up to Leo and the commission!
What casino?
Answer the question.
Uncle Sally's... You see that construction across the lake? He's building a casino over there. He wants to go legit. Turn this city into Las Vegas!
Gambling's illegal.
Yeah, no shit, it's illegal! Which is why he's paid a bunch of money to get the laws changed.
Who else is involved in this?
I don't know. I don't know, I swear it! Look, I told you what you wanted to know. You're gonna let me go now, right?
Yeah, sure. Stupid fucking prick. I'll clean this mess up. No reason for you to stick around.
Remember our deal. I'm expecting a cut of everything you bring in.
Hey, I know how this shit works. You'll get your money. There's a woman named Alma. Helps me out sometimes. Cuban. Mean as fuck. Should talk to her, see if she needs anything. Might be an easy way to bring in some extra money.
Where's she at?
At the warehouse.
All right. What are you gonna do with him?
Fish gotta eat like everyone else.
At what point did you become aware that Sal Marcano wanted to build a casino north of the city?
Pretty early on. Michael Greco told Lincoln about it.
And Lincoln Clay's plan was to specifically target various entities related to Marcano's casino plan?
Between the bribes he was paying out to get gambling legalized and the money needed to pay off the commission, Sal was stretched pretty thin. So Lincoln used that to his advantage. Forced Sal into making some extremely hard decisions.
decisions that would limit his options.
I'm telling you, we make twice as much bread moving heroin as we would from a stupid fucking casino. Maybe three times.
This ain't about the money.
You're joking, right? All I ever heard from you is, don't give me no goddamn excuses, you understand? You pay me what's fucking owed!
You think this is a game, son? And it's my fault for playing along with you. For not setting you straight. But it's not a game. This shit wears on you, grinds you down. I ain't had a decent night's sleep in 43 years. And then after Lucho, shit.
Well, hey, we got the cocksuckers who did that. Every last one of them.
Yeah, and your uncle's still dead, ain't he? Yeah. You think sitting in that chair makes you special, huh? Somehow puts you above all the bullshit. Well, it's the opposite. All it does is paint a giant goddamn bullseye on your forehead. There's a price to be paid for all this, you understand? And I'm tired of paying it. Mainly, I'm worried I'm going to get a phone call telling me you're dead in a gutter somewhere.
What do you expect me to do, huh? Work the front door? Glad hand folks as they come on in, maybe give them a quick slap on the ass?
You run it with me. And here, after a few years, after I know everything's settled down, you'll take over. Find yourself a nice woman. Give me some fucking grandkids.
Sounds boring as fuck.
It's the only way, son. The world is changing. Used to be people knew their place. Now everybody's screaming about equality. And now they all deserve a slice of the pie. Niggas, Micks, Gooks, you name it. Our way of doing things won't work in a world like that. Yeah. You come to me with something like this, Lou, you better be goddamn sure. Yeah.
Lincoln Clay is still alive.
Fuck me.
Can I get a resupply in River Road?
Going at ya. Hang tight.
Anything you want here?
Show me what you got.
Dundee?
Oh!
I'm out of here.
You're him, aren't you? Lincoln Clay.
Vito asked me to come see you.
He wants our guys to do double the runs. Double the runs means double the chances of running into the Coast Guard.
Well, I don't think I'm gonna be too much help dealing with them.
So I will deal with those hijos de la gran puta. I need someone to keep the warehouses full, keep the money coming in.
How much we talking?
Enough to make it worth your troubles. You're gonna be hitting trucks for the contraband.
Seems simple enough. I'll let you know when I get the first truck.
You didn't just save his life, you know? You brought him back. The real Vito. What I mean is, I haven't seen this Vito in a really long time. And I don't want him to go back to the way he was.
You got something to say, Alma, just say it.
What's gonna happen next? You need him? And you need us now. So you give Marcano the fucking he deserves. Is it back in the freezer again?
Would you believe me if I say no?
No, I don't think so. But I believe very few people these days. And if Vito say this is the way things are, that's how they are. If you see any of Greco's men out there, you should deal with them. It will make it easier for us to conduct business. I got my hands on prime shipments out there. Go bust up some heads and bring it back. Back here. I'll take it from there.
Hey, Lincoln. Everything back to normal here now, thanks to you.
Sweet baby.
Shoot this morning.
Burn his ass!
Yeah!
There's our problem.
And ye shall find.
Revolution, isn't there? It's the foundation of our very country. Throwing up the yoke of tyranny. Getting blood for one's very freedom. It's a beautiful thing, dear listen. And if you've got the courage of your convictions, if you're willing to sweat and bleed for them, you may not have my agreement, but you have got my respect. But it seems to me that revolution, the word of these, is being thrown around too freely these days. When you head down to the French ward and see that nest of kids squatting in their little camp there, what do you see? They're dirty. There's no denying that. Messy. Some of them with criminal records. On drugs. Promiscuous. Homosexual. Anti-Christian. They think church is a dirty word. I ask again, what do you see? How do they see themselves? Well, I tell you, I went over there. And I asked him. One boy couldn't have been older than 18, 19. He comes over and we get to talking. Let's call him.
You make me look.
He's barely over. System is keeping you out of school, from getting a job, poor, hungry, or whatever else. Anyway, he tells me that we've got reefer and free love and music, and we don't need what you've got, old man. That's what he said to me. Sex, drugs, music, all they need, and no one's going to tell them otherwise. They think that's brave, moral. Inasmuch as these children believe anything to be moral. From where I'm sitting, there's simply a philosophy of if it feels good, then by golly do it. Follow Rome stuff, essentially. Well, let me tell you, there's a second act to the story. You're not gonna like it, dear listener. In spite of it all, I like this boy. He was smart, articulate. I feel like 20 years younger and a few bad decisions later, I could be him. So I thought I'd go back and talk to him. Bring him a cup of coffee. See what other thoughts might be bouncing around in that head of his. When I got there this morning, I went asking for Bobby. And another boy, older than him, maybe even a little younger, said Bobby was gone.
Your time is up, motherfucker!
Ahead, the fucking ice!
sucker!
Cover me while I reload!
Coño, no necesito esta mierda. What?
Trouble?
Yeah, my whole fucking life. It's a letter from my grandmother. Writes me to wish my mother happy birthday. You know, who she saw get dragged away back in 10 de octubre.
Jesus.
Don't. It's nothing. Fuck it. You got something for me?
I got another truck stash ready for you guys to pick up.
Really? Huh. Arcanos guys are fucking pussies. No problem then?
Not a one on my end.
Good. So it shouldn't be a problem to bring more trucks.
Sure, Alma. I'll see what I can do.
After this guy and I screwed last night, he started yammering on and on about some shit. I was only halfway listening. But he hooked me when he started talking about this warehouse I had my eye on. Turns out they just got some new shipments. I want them. And if you see any of their delivery trucks, bring them back here, and I will see what we can salvage. Vito's had a lifetime of people fucking him over. You're not gonna be another one, are you? The sooner you get those trucks loaded in the warehouse, the sooner we'll bring in some money.
boosters and sends me screaming around the bend so I can talk a mile a minute, 4 hours a day. Swift Cola's what I'm talking about, baby. Swift Cola gives me that wild, zippy zing, that weird, beautiful boost, that crazy, hopped-up brain rust that gets my mojo working. Nothing like a swift kick in the pants to perk up old bad boy Bob.
Swift!
It's cold. It's bold. Buy it by the bottle. Buy it by the can. Buy it by the case. Swift Cola. You dig?
They don't call him Uncle because he's family. It's a sign of respect, you dumb motherfucker. So if I ever catch you...
All units, search is called off. Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrols.